everybody! Oh, it is great to be back to serve as your MC for the 62nd Princess K of the Milky Way. Are you ready?
Yeah!
I thought to myself this morning, I was thinking back and I realized that I've been connected to this Princess K of the Coronation for about 35 years. I know I don't look that old, but I actually started coming and covering this when I was a radio farm broadcaster, and it was always fun to come up here and give the media attention it deserves and interview the new Princess K of the Milky Way. So that goes back quite a few years, and it's great to be back here again. I'm no longer doing the radio broadcasting. I actually have a company called Johnson Auctioneering, and we do fundraising auctions throughout the Midwest, and work for nonprofit organizations. And also another job is a good part-time job. It's a lot of fun. Hard to believe too that in a couple of months I'm gonna begin my 20th season with the Minnesota Timberwolves. So time flies when you're having fun. I'm excited about this season. I tell you what, with Carl Anthony Towns and Ricky Rubio and Tyus Jones and Kevin Garnett, it's gonna be a fun year. I'm excited about that. But you know what, enough about me. We are here tonight to crown a new Princess K of the Milky Way. We have 12 candidates that are backstage. They can't see you, but they can hear you. Now, I think it'd be a good idea to let them know we're here. So, what do you say we make some noise as we get ready to crown the 62nd Princess K of the Milky Way? Let's get loud! It's gonna be a fun night. I love it. Love the enthusiasm. Hey, I wanna say a special thank you to a couple of special folks. How about a big round of applause and thank you to Fairchild and Fairborn? Weren't they great tonight? Very entertaining. You know, we really appreciate them acting as escorts for our Princess K every day in the State Fair Parade. So thank you, Fairchild and Fairborn. At this time, I would ask that you'd please rise and remove your hats. In honor of all the servicemen and women serving our country here and abroad, and now to perform our national anthem, please welcome 2014 Princess K finalist, Michaela Foe. Michaela. Thank you so much, Michaela Thoe, and our national anthem. Great job. And now please turn your attention to the screen.
In my family, farming is a tradition. Our farm has been passed down from generation to generation, and we take pride in caring for our animals and producing delicious milk, cheese, and yogurt for you all to enjoy. That's why I love telling my family's story. Both my sisters have been advocates for dairy through the Princess K program too, And even after their year has ended, they have continued to tell the story of hardworking dairy farmers that care about the land and their cattle. Making sure that the milk families drink is safe is a full-time job. That's why we go through several steps on the farm to keep all of our equipment and our cows clean. First, the cows live here, where they are protected from the elements and have access to food and water and are bedded with sand. Then, once it is time for milking, their teats are cleaned and milk is collected with sanitized equipment. It is then taken by a milk truck to a processing plant where it is tested, packaged, and transported to your local grocery store.
Dairy products are an important part of a healthy diet, and that is why we support initiatives like Fuel Up to Play 60. Fuel Up to Play 60 is a program that encourages school-aged children to eat a healthy diet and to get at least 60 minutes of play a day. It teaches students at a young age that being healthy is important, and part of being healthy is eating nutrient-rich foods like milk, cheese, and yogurt. Programs like Fuel Up to Play 60 can help build habits that will help them be healthy for the rest of their lives.
My family and I work hard day after day to keep our cows happy and healthy. While we take pride in caring for our animals, we also care about the environment. That is why we have a manure management system in place to prevent the manure from entering the river and changing the amount of nutrients in the water. We spread the manure from our cows onto our fields, where it naturally enhances the soil to help grow nutritious crops to feed our cows.
I've been on a lot of farms throughout the state of Minnesota. Here, we milk 105 cows, and I've been on farms that are both larger and smaller. From farm to farm, there might be a difference in the breeds of cattle or the amount of land, but one thing doesn't change. All farmers care for their animals. Here, we make decisions every day to make sure that calves are fed, cows are milked, and crops are cared for. It takes a lot of dedication to run a farm, but we love our job.
My family owns and operates our farm near Goodyear, Minnesota. Cows like ours are cared for by families, just like 98% of dairy farms. My 8 siblings and I, we all take turns feeding calves, milking, and making sure our crops and cows are healthy. My favorite chore on the farm is milking cows, where I get to work with my dad and my other siblings. We make sure each cow is cared for and stays healthy to produce wholesome and fresh milk. My family, we take pride in making sure our crops and cows are healthy.
I really like running out here on the road that leads to my farm. I run a lot, especially in the summertime. And when I'm done, I always make sure to refuel with a glass of chocolate milk. It has a lot of nutrients and is the perfect fix for my tired muscles. When I refuel with milk, I feel better and am able to improve my performance. It tastes great too. These days, milk goes beyond just making healthy bones. In addition to calcium, milk has protein and vitamin D. It's the perfect mixture of nutrients I need to keep running fast.
My family works hard every day to make sure cows have a healthy life. Heifer calves start out in hutches for 10 to 12 weeks. Then they'll move to a larger group pen. And after they have their first calf, they move to a freestall barn like this, where they're milked twice a day, every day. We work closely with our veterinarians and nutritionists to make sure our cows get the best care possible.
Dairy farmers need tools to properly care for their cows and produce wholesome and nutritious milk. We have installed equipment on our farm that is making our calves a lot happier. The automatic calf feeding system allows the calves to eat whenever they are hungry, and it monitors how much milk the calves are drinking each day. This system also ensures that our calves are healthy and growing as they should, which is a top priority on our farm and many dairy farms around the nation.
There are 7 kinds of dairy cattle, and they are Ayrshire, Brown Swiss, Holstein, Guernsey, Jersey, Milking Shorthorn, and Red and White Holstein. On my family farm, we have all 7 breeds and crossbreds where we milk them twice a day. Not only do all of these cows look different, but they also have different strengths and qualities. Brown Swiss produce milk, which makes great cheese, and Holsteins are famous for producing large quantities of milk, and Jerseys are known for their small stature and calm demeanor. And my favorite cow is the Jersey cow.
Growing up on my family's dairy farm has inspired me to study animal science at college this upcoming fall to learn more about how to take better care of my family's cows. Like my sisters and I, many other farm kids have pursued college education to develop skills and learn about new technologies that we can bring back to the farm. By applying the knowledge we gain while studying at college, we have the ability to make our farms more sustainable and efficient, improving our livelihoods while using less inputs. Young people who choose this career path often strive to come back home to the farm and use the information they have learned to advance the farm and the dairy community.
No matter where you are, farm families like mine stay busy all year round. It starts with caring for our cows each and every day, making sure they are fed, clean, and healthy. In the spring, we spread natural fertilizer on the land so that we can grow wheat, corn, soybeans, and alfalfa. On those hot summer days, we harvest the hay and monitor the pastures to maintain food for our cattle. By fall, we spend day and night harvesting the crops for the next year. And on those cold winter days, we make sure all of our equipment is working properly so that we can do it all over again.
There they are, your 12 finalists for Princess Cave, the Milky Way. We're going to be meeting them in just a couple of minutes. You know, there are people from all across the state who actually make this program happen. And I'd like you to please stand up and be acknowledged as I introduce you. Midwest Dairy Minnesota Division Board members, will you please stand? Midwest Dairy CEO Mike Kruger. The Midwest Dairy Princess Committee. All past Princess K's, please stand. Thank you for being here. The Dairy Star for assembling our program each year. AMPI from New Ulm, you know them as the creamery that donates over 1,000 pounds of butter each year. We mentioned Fairborn and Fairchild, and the one and only, Scott Boland of the Princess Cave. Aren't they great? The person I'm about to introduce has had quite a year in representing the dairy farmers and dairy industry of Minnesota. She's done an outstanding job on behalf of the proud dairy farmers of Minnesota. She's from Norwood, Young America. Would you please welcome your current Princess K of the Milky Way, Jenny Haler. Year has been almost life-changing. I mean, what was it like serving as an ambassador on behalf of the 3,600 Minnesota dairy farmers?
You know, it's really hard to put into words what it's like to have 3,600 families standing behind you for an entire year.
Great experience, I imagine. In a matter of minutes, we're going to crown the 62nd Princess K of the Milky Way. What advice would you give to the new Princess K?
I'm going to give her the advice that was passed down to me, and that's simply to soak in every single moment. The year goes by way too quickly, and you are truly carrying on and continuing a cherished, beloved, iconic Minnesotan tradition.
It does go by fast. It seems like just the other day that we crowned you Princess K.
It really does.
You bet, you bet. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it again for your 61st Princess K of the Milky Way, Jenny Haler. Well, I think we've waited long enough. Are you ready? Are you ready to meet the 12 candidates for Princess K of the Milky Way? I said, are you ready? All right. Let's meet these 12 outstanding young ladies. And our first candidate represents Stearns County, is the daughter of Victor and Ann. This fall, she will be heading to Ridgewater College to study dairy management. She enjoys baking, running, and scrapbooking, and is involved in PAS, post-secondary agriculture students at Ridgewater. Ladies and gentlemen, from Melrose, please welcome Morgan Uphoff! question. You know, I see you're involved in PAS at college. Tell us more about that.
PAS stands for Post-Secondary Agricultural Students Organization, and I am involved in Ridgewater in the dairy specialist team, where we had the chance to go to nationals, and my team placed second in the nation, and that's a memory I will never forget.
Wow, congratulations. Why is Princess K important, do you think, to the dairy farmers of Minnesota?
Because the dairy industry is extremely important to Minnesota, it is extremely important that we have a Princess K program. It is hard for dairy farmers to get out and about, being that they're so busy on the farm. So it is a good opportunity for us to have a dairy princess that can go out and represent the over 3,600 dairy farmers in Minnesota.
All right. And I know you actively help out on the farm. Is there one job that you do that's your favorite?
Of course, I love doing everything on the farm, but milking cows stands out the most to me. It is a great way to balance quality time with family and quality time with the cows.
That sounds great. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Morgan Uphoff, again from Stearns County. Our next finalist comes from Norwood Young America and is the daughter of Jeff and Tina. She will attend Northeast Iowa Community College this fall for dairy science and agriculture business. In her spare time, she's involved in 4-H, Dairy Quiz Bowl, Dairy Judging, and coaches community sports programs. Representing Carver County, please welcome Carly Vinkemeyer. Been, you know, going through the judging process with these other young ladies?
It's been super exciting, and it has been a little bit nerve-wracking as well. But we spent our day on Tuesday getting judged, and then we had a little bit of fun and went bowling.
All right, sounds good. I was curious, what is your favorite dairy product?
I'd have to probably say ice cream.
Yeah, it's a good choice. I agree, yeah. And I also have to ask you, you know, you're going to be heading off to Northeast Iowa Community College this fall. What made you decide on that school?
I chose Northeast Iowa Community College because of all the different technology opportunities I have. I'll be able to work with robotic milking systems, automatic calf feeders, and hopefully maybe drones.
Sounds good. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Carly Vinkemeyer. And our next young lady represents Wright County and is the daughter of Chris and Harlan. She begins her sophomore year at South Dakota State University this fall, pursuing an agriculture education degree. At college, she's active in SDSU Dairy Club, Sigma Alpha Sorority, and Collegiate FFA. She enjoys hiking, running, and being on the lake. From Howard Lake, please welcome Kayla Mock. Wow, Kayla, you got some fans here tonight. Hey, good evening. There they are. I have to ask you, Kayla, did you ever envision yourself being on stage here at the Minnesota State Fair as part of this Princess K coronation?
You know, ever since I went to the State Fair, I've loved going to the Dairy Goodness Building and checking out those butter sculptures. When I was little, it's been a goal of mine, and it's finally came true, and spending the last few days in the summer with these 11 incredible ladies has been a true blessing.
All right, and tell us a little bit about your home farm near Howard Lake.
We live on a dairy farm just north of Howard Lake where we milk primarily Holsteins. We're a fourth generation dairy farm, and my favorite part about living on the farm is that we get to get up every morning. I get to work alongside my sisters, my mom, and my dad.
Doesn't get any better than that. Now, you're a sophomore this year at South Dakota State. Where do you see yourself after graduation from college?
Upon graduation from SDSU, I would love to be an agricultural educator and FFA advisor because of the impact FFA has had on me.
Sounds good. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Kayla Mock. And now, let's bring out a candidate representing Goodhue County. She is the daughter of Kent and Deborah and will attend the University of Minnesota Crookston this fall to pursue a degree in animal science. She enjoys showing cattle, running, and skiing. She's involved in 4-H and FFA and is currently serving on the Goodhue County Junior Fair Board. From Lake City, please welcome Maggie Mills. Candidates here tonight, I see, you're involved in 4-H and FFA. What is it about these two organizations that have such an interest for you?
Yeah, well, I started 4-H when I was very young, and then I did join FFA when I was in high school, and now the Princess K program through being a finalist, and just having these organizations was such a blessing, and now being able to participate in dairy judging to showing cattle, it's just been a complete opportunity and blessing.
All right. Now, you're pursuing a degree in animal science, and what eventually would you like to do with that degree?
Yeah, so I will be a freshman this fall studying animal science, and I'm hoping to also do communications. So being able to continue to expand my knowledge of the dairy industry, as well as the agricultural industry, and then being able to communicate with people and really share my personal story with them so that they understand why we do what we do on our dairy farms.
Very good. And what have you enjoyed most about the past couple of days?
I can honestly say that the finalists have made my whole experience just amazing. They've always just been supporting and we always have fun. So just being able to meet these girls and making all these memories and friendships that will last forever.
That is great to hear. Ladies and gentlemen, Maggie Mills. Well, our next candidate is heading into her sophomore year at the University of Minnesota, studying agricultural education. She is the daughter of Jerome and Karen, is involved in Gopher Dairy Club, Ag Ed Club, and Beta Clovia sorority at school. She enjoys golfing and spending time with her friends, family, and her dog Magic. From Rochester, representing Olmsted County, here is Ellen Sheehan. Well, hello, Ellen. So far, what has been, this experience been like for you?
This experience has been absolutely amazing. There's no other program that will give you so many skills and to let you meet so many amazing people, such as the Dairy Farmers of Minnesota.
All right, and what is your favorite way to promote Minnesota's dairy industry?
I love going and talking to school children. They just want to learn, they have no idea what's going on, and it's so exciting to be able to teach them what we're doing on our farm.
Now, I mentioned that you enjoy your dog, Magic, and I have to ask because I had a dog, and he was named Magic, and I named him after Magic Johnson. How did you come up with the name Magic for your dog?
Well, when we went to go pick out our St. Bernard puppy, she was just magic. She brought so much magic into our lives, and her name just fits her perfectly.
It sounds like it. All right. Very good. Ladies and gentlemen, Ellen Sheehan. Well, our next finalist comes from Greenbush, Minnesota. Yeah. She's a daughter of Doug and Karina. She'll be starting her junior year at North Dakota State University this fall, studying animal science with minors in ag business and agronomy. She's looking forward to playing intramural sports at school, enjoys volleyball, singing, and four-wheeling. Representing Roseau County, please welcome Michelle Green.
Hello,
well. I gotta know, what made you become interested in getting involved in like Princess K?
You know, there's not a whole lot of knowledge up in northern Minnesota, and...
You know what she means.
Yeah, sorry about that. But, you know, all I was really exposed to was Dairy magazines, and thankfully I've had some great friends, and they've gotten me to where I am today.
All right, very good. Now, I see that you're looking forward to playing intramural sports at North Dakota State. So what kind of sports do you enjoy?
I really enjoy volleyball and basketball. I played in college, and I'm just ready to get back out on the court and tie up them sneakers again.
Now, as you head off to college, what are you going to miss about the farm?
I'm going to miss being with my family every single day and the special cows that I have bonds with and some of the calves, but I'm planning on milking cows at NDSU, so a little home away from home.
And you'll get a chance when you come home to visit.
Oh, definitely.
All right, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Michelle Green. Well, next we have a representative from Maurer County. The daughter of Rick and Tracy, she will be a senior at the University of Wisconsin River Falls this fall and is studying dairy science management. At school, she's involved with the UWRF Dairy Club and InterVarsity. She enjoys dancing, showing cattle, and watching movies. From Adams, Minnesota, here is Mackenzie Smith. You know, it's not going to be long, and you're going to be graduating from college. So what's next for you after graduation?
After graduation, I plan to find a dairy nutrition job, as well as move closer to home to help my dad with the calf management program.
All right. Hey, sounds like a great plan. Do you feel that the general public has an understanding of the dairy industry, or do we have a lot of educating yet to do?
I feel that... The general public has a very good understanding, but there's always more educating to do.
All right. And what was the best part about growing up on a dairy farm?
My favorite part about growing up on a dairy farm is spending time with my family as well as the animals. My favorite animal is a cow, so being able to just be on the farm and also share my story with others is a great experience for me.
All right. That's great. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Mackenzie Smith. Well, our next finalist is from Goodyear and will be a sophomore at the University of Wisconsin-Stout this fall, where she is studying cross-media graphics management. The daughter of Ted and Laura. At school, she's involved in Stout Typographical Society, Honors College, and FFA. She enjoys photography, painting, and screen printing. Representing Goodyear County, here is Samantha Keller. All right, well, hi, Samantha. Start off by just telling us a little bit about your family farm near Goodyear.
I live and work on my family's farm with my parents and my 8 other siblings. We milk 180 cows twice a day in our milking parlor, and all of us siblings, we all take turns feeding calves, milking, and making sure our crops and our cows stay healthy.
All right. Now, I see that you're studying cross-media graphics management. Tell us what that's all about.
Well, it's more of the business side of graphic design, marketing, and advertising, and hopefully in the future I'll be able to promote dairy in one way or another.
All right. Hey, that sounds good. Now, how would you describe the last couple of days here in the Twin Cities for you?
It's been an absolute blast working with all these other girls. We've made so many memories, had so many laughs. It's just been an overall great experience.
That is good to hear. Ladies and gentlemen, there she is, Samantha Keller! next we have a candidate representing McLeod County. She is the daughter of Alan and Lisa and will be attending Southwest Minnesota State University this fall, where she will begin her freshman year studying secondary education social sciences. She enjoys reading, writing, driving tractor, and milking cows. From Lester Prairie, here is Rachel Stender. Good evening, Rachel. Now, tell us, what has been your favorite part of the last couple of days going through this process?
My favorite part has been spending time with the other 11 wonderful ladies back there. And I don't know if you can hear them, but we're singing, dancing, and cheering extra loud.
I noticed you get along really well, you really do. Now, there are many ways to promote our dairy industry. What is one way you feel works well in getting the word out?
Well, one of my favorite ways to get the word out is actually going directly into classrooms, talking with the kids, and letting them know what's going on, because they take that back to their parents, and there the word goes.
There you go. Now, you say you enjoy driving tractor, and you enjoy milking cows. Is that something you're going to miss a lot when you head off to college?
I am going to miss it like crazy, and when I come home, I'm going to love spending time with all the cows, and of course, driving the red tractors.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, how about it for Rachel Stender? Our next finalist hails from Hamburg, Minnesota, and is the daughter of Jim and Jody. She will start her sophomore year at Minnesota State Mankato this fall. At MSU, she's involved in choir, intramural volleyball, and Alpha Chi Omega sorority. Now, she enjoys showing cattle, dairy judging, and crafting in her spare time. Representing Sibley County, would you please welcome Jennifer Elfke? Start off by telling us a little bit about your home farm near Hamburg, right?
Correct. For sixth generation, my family farm has been so dedicated and so committed to producing the highest quality dairy foods and milk, and we are so proud to do that. And on my family farm, it's giving the utmost care for our cattle and the land. And the cattle on my farm are Jersey cows, and those little brown cows will always have a special place in my heart.
All right, that's good to hear. Now, We always are educating the public about the dairy industry. What is one thing that you wish the public knew more about dairy farmers?
I wish they knew how much time goes into producing the highest quality dairy foods, and that's something that we maybe take for granted, and how dedicated we are every single day, 365 days a year. This is our job and it's our passion, and we absolutely love it.
You mentioned that you really enjoy showing cattle. What is it you think that makes you enjoy that so much?
Well, for many, many years, I've been showing dairy cattle. It's been one of my favorite things to do, and it's definitely a family tradition, as it's a tradition for us to be dairy farmers and for the 3,600 dairy farmers in Minnesota also.
All right, thank you so much. We wish you the best of luck. Let's hear it for Jennifer Elfke, ladies and gentlemen. And now, from Douglas County, here is the daughter of Mark and Michelle. She will start her sophomore year at Concordia College in Moorhead this fall, where she's studying speech pathology. While at school, she also participates in intramural sports and hall council. In her spare time, she enjoys showing cattle, sports, and spending time on the lake. From Hoffman, please welcome Kylie Bernholz. Spending time on the lake. So what sort of water activities do you enjoy?
Well, honestly, I like just laying on a floaty. That's pretty nice. I also like the high of action sports like wakeboarding and kneeboarding and tubing.
Sounds good to me. You know, I haven't brought this up yet, but I'd like to get your opinion on, you know, you're going to be sitting in a cooler and getting sculptured out of butter. What do you think about that experience coming up?
Oh, that's so exciting. We're going to be sitting in a cooler pretty much all day. It's about 40 degrees. I'm so excited to bring home my 90 pounds of butter.
What are you going to do with it?
Well, hopefully my family doesn't fight over it.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be fun. So, now, when you first went off to college, did you find yourself really missing the farm a lot?
I did miss the farm. I live right next to a street, and for about 2 weeks, I could not get over cars. But, yeah, I really miss the farm, but I know it's in really good hands.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, how about it for Kylie Fernholz? And now let's bring out the representative from Wabasha County. She is the daughter of Bruce and Natalie. And will start her freshman year at Iowa State University in the fall to pursue a degree in animal science. She enjoys showing cattle, baking, and being with her family and friends. From Plainview, here is Callie Becker. Hey, what has it been like the last couple of days?
It's been absolutely crazy. It's been such a great experience. I've gotten to know the 11 other finalists so well. I've learned so much, and it's just been awesome.
Tell us a little bit about your family farm near Plainview, right?
Yeah, so we have actually been farming on our farm for over 150 years. So on our farm, we really care about taking care of our cows as well as maintaining our land so that hopefully we can be sustainable for the next 150 years, creating that wholesome product that we all love.
All right. Now, you're going to be studying animal science at Iowa State. Why did you choose to pursue that particular degree?
When I moved to the farm in third grade, I really didn't know much about agriculture. But when I got to see all the people that farmers work with, like our veterinarian, it really inspired me. So I got more involved with agriculture, and now it's become my passion, and being able to work with people and animals is absolutely something I'm looking forward to in the future.
All right, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Callie Becker. Wow, I told you we had 12 outstanding candidates tonight. I tell you what, what do you think? What do you think of these 12 candidates? Let's hear it. Come on, let's make some noise for this year's finalists. Fine for Princess K of the Milky Way. And I tell you what, let's bring back all of these beautiful young ladies back right now out of the stage. Let's bring them on out here, and let's hear it for our 12 finalists for Princess K of the Milky Way. Hey, we're getting closer to that big moment. We're getting very close. But at this time, I would like to introduce to you the chair of Midwest Dairy Association Minnesota Division Board. He is a dairy producer from Clitheroe. Please welcome Mr. Ken Herbertson. Ken.
Thanks, Rod. You know, as I was coming in here tonight, I couldn't help but notice the cheering sections. First, I come across a bunch of folks in pink t-shirts. And then there was some in green t-shirts, and there's some in blue t-shirts. And I just know you came a long ways to have fun at this party. And we have a great coronation going on here, but you know, without the cheering sections, we wouldn't be having this big fun party, so let's hear it for the cheering sections here tonight. Thank you, and good evening. Tomorrow, as you know, is the first of 12 days that most of you know as the Great Minnesota Get-Together. As we dairy farmers call it, an exceptional opportunity. It lets us remind people who we are and how much they enjoy what we and our cows produce. We'll share the great taste of dairy with thousands of consumers and provide them with some insight on how we care for our animals and the land where we live. Our dairy stands have been very popular at Minnesota State Fair for many years, but dairy farmers have been leaders in the health and wellness of families for a lot longer. In fact, we are celebrating the 100th anniversary of the National Dairy Council this year. Now, you might not be familiar with the Dairy Council, but it has shaped the health and the lives of every one of you. Because of dairy farmers being leaders in health and wellness, we have a national school lunch program, and we have guidelines from our government for good eating. In the next 12 days, something close to 2 million people will be attending the fair. And a large percentage of those folks are going to come. They're coming to see the cattle and the other animals. They're coming to see the butter sculptures. They're going to watch Princess Kay and her court travel down the streets of the state fair. In short, they're here to have a bunch of fun. And as they're here to have a bunch of fun, we as dairy farmers have one of the fair's top food vendors with our Dairy Goodness Bar in the dairy building and the all-you-can-drink milk stand. This year we're introducing a new one-time flavor of the fair at your Dairy Goodness Bar. It's called the Salted Caramel Puff. It's a malt or a sundae and was chosen by online voting last May. I hope you all try it. I already have, and trust me, it's a winner. That's a legacy that we're very proud of, just like the legacy of Princess Kay and tonight's event. If you're anything like me, you're looking forward to the next 12 days, and we're honored that tonight's coronation is the kickoff to the Great Minnesota State Fair. On behalf of the dairy farm families from all across Minnesota, we say thank you to our outgoing Princess Kay, Jenny Haler. Yeah, let's hear it for Jenny. Jenny, you've done an outstanding job representing us, going out to show dairy to the school children and so many events you've done. I know you've just done a great job, and I just want to say thank you from all of us. We also want to wish the very best to the new Princess Kay, whoever she may be. Thank you.
Thank you again. Appreciate it. Well, Jenny, your reign as the 61st Princess Kay of the Milky Way is almost complete. And I know you've had a very memorable year representing the Minnesota dairy industry. So ladies and gentlemen, for one final time, I would like to introduce to you your reigning Princess Kay of the Milky Way, Jenny Haler.
Once upon a time, a little girl tugged on her boots and marched out to her kingdom, ready to conquer the world. Open blue skies greeted her, and the smell of fresh-cut hay still lingered in the air from the day before. as she made her way down to her castle with her two sisters, a strange combination of excitement and nervousness swelled within her. Halter in hand, she crawled into the pen, eyes locked on number 34. Back and forth she ran, trailing the black and white youngster for the whole while, and sometime after manically chasing her calf, she managed to successfully step out of the pen and onto the green grass side by side with her first Holstein show heifer, Princess. Sensing Princess's eagerness to explore the open area, the little girl gripped the black roped halter so tightly her fingers began to turn white and shake. Not out of fear, but anticipation of the wild ride that lay ahead. 15 short years later, she found herself fastening on a pair of black suede strappy heels with the same excitement and nervousness as she had before, only greater. Proudly making her way to center stage after hearing her name, her emotions intensified with each step. Reciting and re-reciting her answers in her head from earlier, looking straight into the paralyzing darkness, and clasping hands with the young woman next to her, she waited. By now, her emotions were bursting at the seams and her breath hardly noticeable. A small touch to her head immobilized her entire body, and she dropped to her knees instantly. Her hand covered her mouth in shock, realizing that she had just been crowned the 61st Princess K of the Milky Way. She began to shake, not out of fear, but anticipation of the wild ride that lay ahead. 1 year and 1 week ago, this was my story and fairy tale. On this same stage tonight, in these same shoes, but now with a changed perspective. After 12 months of traveling roughly 6,500 miles of Minnesota and making over 150 appearances, as Princess K, the places I've been and the people I've met have truly changed my perspective. I found that the role of Princess K is not simply viewed as a passionate princess, but also a devoted leader, a role model, and a spokesperson. And while many saw me as these things throughout my reign, I found myself to be a student, a listener, and a learner. Throughout my year, I learned kindness from the students that always had a compliment ready and waited my arrival. Through this role, I learned to imagine and dream bigger from those who hosted dairy events larger than 4,000 people simply to showcase their farm and their passion. Throughout this role, I learned strength and leadership from the Fuel to Play 60 ambassadors who put in countless hours to advocate the healthy lifestyle, including 3 servings of dairy each day and traveling across the nation to tell others of its importance. Throughout this role, I learned that farmers are setting the bar high for my retirement age. But through this role, they also taught me that the true meaning of humility and what it feels like to have 3,600 dairy farm families supporting and encouraging me on what was truly the greatest adventure of my life to date. 15 short years ago, I would not have believed I would be on the stage not once, but twice. And now, as I stand before you all with my final remarks as your 61st Princess K of the Milky Way, I know I have only merely touched the surface of where this wild ride will take me. My most sincere thank you goes out to all those who played a part in this whirlwind of a year, and finally to the farmers. It has been an honor to serve you as your 61st Princess K of the Milky Way.
Well, we're getting closer. All right, all 12 of our candidates were eligible to apply for one of three $500 scholarships from the Midwest Dairy Association. We had a panel of judges that reviewed the applications earlier this month, and they based their criteria on academic excellence, leadership qualities, participation in dairy activities, and future goals. Now, we announced the scholarship winners this evening at the banquet. I'm going to let you know who they are right now. Our scholarship winners, when I announce your name, please step forward. From Greenbush, Michelle Green. Also winning a $500 scholarship is Samantha Keller from Goodyear. And our third scholarship goes to Kayla Mock from Howard Lake. Well, we're getting closer. Right now, it's time to find out who will receive our Miss Congeniality Award. Let's see, I've got the envelope here. Let me see, if I think I've got it somewhere here. All right, Miss Congeniality. Jenny, I'll give you the honors. Open that envelope up and we're gonna see who Miss Congeniality is going to be. All right, and we have a gift here. Okay, if you want to present the gift, I will make the announcement that this year's Miss Congeniality is from Douglas County. Kylie Fernholz, congratulations, Miss Congeniality. Gift is on behalf of the Midwest Dairy Association. Well, let me see if I can find another envelope here. All right, there it is. In this envelope are the names of our three finalists. Now remember, when I read the names, they are in no particular order. As I read the names of the three finalists, I ask that you please proceed to center stage. So let's see who our three finalists are. This sealed pretty good. All right, again, in no particular order, our three finalists are Ellen Sheehan from Olmsted County, another one of our finalists, Kylie Fernholz from Dallas, buddy. One more finalist to announce. One more. Kayla Mock from Wright County. The final three, our three finalists. Oh, here we go. It is time to find out who the 62nd Princess K of the Milky Way is going to be. Let's open this envelope. All right. Jenny, I'm going to show you this, and we're going to let you crown the new Princess K. All right? Got it? Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. In a moment, you will find out who this year's Princess K of the Milky Way is.
Second Princess K of the Milky Way!
Congratulations. What did it feel like when that crown was placed on your head?
The most incredible feeling, honestly indescribable.
Wow, it's been quite an experience. Now, you're going to get to work almost immediately. You're going to get up bright and early tomorrow morning. Is there anything you'd like to say to this crowd and to all the dairy producers in the state of Minnesota?
I would just like to say, first of all, thank you so much for coming out here to support me and these 11 incredible ladies. And to the dairy farmers, thank you much for giving us all this opportunity, because it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. So thank you so much.
You've got an exciting year ahead of you. Is there one thing that you're really looking forward to the coming year?
I guess I'm really looking forward to classroom visits. I can't wait to educate people about dairy and all the good things in the dairy community.
Can you believe it? You're Princess Kay of the Milky Way.
Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up again for our 60-second Princess Kay of the Milky Way, Kay Lamarck! Ladies and gentlemen, this has truly been a night to remember. Congratulations to all of our candidates. You all did a fantastic job. I want to remind all of our candidates, please stay on stage for group photos. And I would also like to invite the parents of our new Princess Kay to also come on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been my pleasure to serve as your MC tonight. Thank you all so much for coming. Have a safe trip home. And we'll see you at this year's Minnesota State Fair. Good night, everyone.